We know Anish Giri beat Magnus Carlsen, but did you know that Anish beat Magnus on the exact same date 12 years in the past? He did it like this. The knight's under attack. He doesn't want to move to the awkward a6 square, so instead, he sacrifices a knight. Because after takes, takes, and takes, he takes the knight with tempo on the queen, and then he takes back the rook, and it's actually even material. But he's not done yet. e4, the knight jumps away. e3, look at this move. It cuts off the queen's defense, and you can't take with the queen because the rook's guarding the pawn. So instead, Magnus moves to queen b2, takes, and the idea is maybe takes. But if you do that, e2, you sacrifice the queen. And after that, you're totally lost as white. So instead, if you want to try and block the pawn, you still sacrifice the queen. And you go this way, and you're like, wait, how does this actually work? Because bishop h3. And the only thing left to do is this, and it is completely winning for black. Magnus tries bishop e3, but queen g4, and there's no way to recover the material. Happy learning, everyone.